So in the series of learning programming in C, we are discussing some programs on 2D array. We have discussed theory part of 2D array. In the previous video, I have discussed a simple program like how to read elements of a 2D array, how to print those elements and how to calculate sum of that 2D array, or you can say a matrix. 2D array is what? It's like a matrix. In this video, we will see how to do transpose of a matrix, how to print transpose of a matrix, right? We'll discuss some programs on, like, first of all, on a single matrix, then we'll take matrix, or then we'll take 2 to 3 matrix, and then we'll like addition of 2 matrix, multiplication of 2 matrix, these kind of programs. So on matrix, we will discuss basically like 6 to 7 programs, right? I'll first of all show you the logic here on this whiteboard. We'll discuss try run that program here, then I'll show you that program on my laptop. So now let us discuss how to print transpose of a matrix. I hope you know what is transpose. If not, let me tell you. Suppose this is a matrix 1 2 3 4 5 6. I'm just taking matrix of 2 into 3, means 2 rows and 3 columns. So transpose, how you will get? By changing rows into columns and columns into rows, you can say, right? See, this is row and these are columns, 0 and 1 0 1 2. So if you want to print transpose of a matrix, then how you will get? Change this row into column, means this is row 1 2 3, it should be first column. This is second row 4 5 6, now it is second column. If you have third row, that would be here third column, but we have only 2 rows, so that is why here only 2 columns would be there. We have 3 columns, means 3 rows would be there in that transpose, because we are changing rows into columns. So this is, you can say, transpose of this matrix. Now this matrix is of size 3 into 2. This also you need to take care, right? If rows and columns are having different size, if 3 into 3, that is fine. It should be, transpose will be also 3 into 3 size, right? So how we will print this thing, the transpose of a matrix? First we will read a matrix, right? Multiple ways can be there. I'll discuss only one way here, and I'll give some hint about another way, but you have to do at your own. You have to print the transpose of a matrix by using that another method, right? That is assignment for you. First method I'm going to discuss here only. So first of all, obviously we have to declare this 2 and 3, sizes 2 to 3, I and j. So now I'm going to read the matrix first using scanf. No need to, I think, tell you this thing, because I have told this thing many times clearly. I have discussed this thing, right? J++, 2 loops, 1 for row, outer loop for row, that would be 2 rows, so 0 to 2. This inner loop would be 4 columns, means for actual printing, taking the values, so 0 to 3. And here we will use a scanf, %d, address of a of I and j. That's it. This is to read the matrix, right? Now directly we are going to print, right? Or maybe if you want to print this matrix also, you can print. In the previous video we have discussed same 4 loops, and rather than scanf we will use printf, and rather than address of, we will simply write a of ij, and you can print this matrix also, right? But here I'm just printing the transpose of this matrix, so I'm using that logic only, right? Now see, the outer loop is what? Outer loop handles rows, number of rows. So in transpose we are having 3 rows, so 0, index would be 0 1 and 2, right? Means outer loop should run from 0 to 3, means 3 times ultimately it should run. So I is equal to 0, I less than 3, and I plus plus. Here we are having only 2 rows, so outer loop is from 0 to 2, means 2 times, but here 3 times, because we are going to interchange the rows into columns. Means that is now 3 into 2, 3 into 2, this 3 into 2. So now 3 rows and 2 columns. So that is why outer loop would be from 0 to 3. You need to take care of this thing. And inner loop would be what? Less than 2, only 2 times, because it would be having only 2 columns, right? And J++. Now how to print this thing? Printf percentage d, right? Need to print in a matrix, like in a matrix form. So after this we have obviously some space would be there, so you can use slash t, or maybe you can just print one space, enter, like one space, and after that you can close this. So that is also fine, right? I am using slash t, I like slash t. Right? So now how to print a of, how to print now, rather than ij, you have to print j and I, because we are going to interchange rows into columns. This you need to take care, right? See, I am going to dry run this, then you will get it better, right? And then one printf also, slash n also, to make this into output into a matrix form, right? So this is how you can print transpose of a matrix, simple. That's it. Let me dry run this program. I hope the working of this for loop is clear. So I'm going to start from this only. See, I is equal to 0 here. When compiler will come here, then first for 6 elements size would be allocated, and one element, one variable is what I, one variable is what j. It is having at starting some garbage value, but now I is equal to 0. Condition true, yes, enter. J is equal to 0, condition true, yes, enter. A of j I. Now A of j means 0, I means 0. Means you are accessing 0, 0, this element, right? 0, 0, row is also 0, column is also 0. So A of 0, 0 means 1, it will print 1. Okay, fine. J plus plus now, j is 1 because we are in this inner loop now. Condition, yes, 1 less than 2. Condition 2, again enter here. Now, one space, like tab here. A of, now j value is 1 and I value is still 0. So, we are accessing now 1, 0 element, A of 1, 0. Which element? A of 1, 0, this element. Because row is 1, row index is 1 and column index is 0. So, we are accessing this element now. So, it will print 4 here rather than 2. And that's exactly we want, right? Now j plus plus, j becomes 2, but condition not true, exit from the inner loop. After this inner loop, next line is slash n, so cursor will be next line, right? Now I plus plus, now I becomes 1, condition again true, again enter here, again j would be initialized with 0. Condition true, yes, enter here. Now j is what? 0, but I is 1. See, I has been updated, that is 1. So now we are accessing A of 0, 1. A of 0, 1. 0 is row and 1 is column. So 2, this, we are accessing this value. So 2 would be printed here. Now J plus plus, J becomes 1. Yes, condition true. Again enter here, and A of JI. J means J also 1 and I also 1. 1, 1. So 1, 1 is this element. 1 and 1. 5. 5 would be printed here. Now J becomes 2. Condition not true, exit from this loop, slash n means cursor will be next line. Now I plus plus, now I becomes 2. Again enter, condition true, 2 less than 3, again enter here, and j would be again initialized with 0. So again, what would be printed output would be there, 3 and 6. I guess no need to dry run further, you can do it yourself. I hope you got it, right? So this is what exactly we want. This is what transpose of a matrix. Now I hope you got why I am writing here A of ji rather than ij. This is the only change. And one more change in the loop, upper bound of the loop. Because rows are now 3, so that should be 3. Here it is 2. Inner loop would run for 2 times. Here it was 3 times. Right? But if matrix is of same size, like 3 into 3, rows and columns are same. So here also 3, here also 3, here also 3, here also 3. Because both rows and columns are same. 4 into 4, that is also same. If different, then only you need to take care. Right? This is one method. Second method is, maybe one matrix is this and I want you take another matrix B. And first of all, find out the transpose of this matrix and store into B matrix and then print this matrix. So this transpose would be suppose in B, first of all, that should be stored in B, and now you have to print B. Here I am not taking another matrix, I am just taking one matrix and just printing the transpose. But now I want to take another matrix, store the transpose there and then print. Now how you will do this thing? You can, this is also another way if you want to do like this, in this way. So you can do. So I guess you can do it yourself because logic is clear to you. Transpose is clear. What is transpose? The logic is clear to you. I guess you can do it. So better to do it. This is assignment for you, and you can send me like on my Instagram. You can message me on my Instagram account. Like you can take a screenshot and you can send me that program, right? But please don't copy and paste from internet before, you know, taking the help from internet. Like directly don't search how to print transpose of a matrix. Understand the logic here. Try this method your own, and then if you're not getting, then you can take help, right, from Google Bhaiya. Now let me show you the output of this thing on my laptop, right? So now let me create one file for you. I'm taking name transpose matrix .c, right? Header file, then you will take what main function, and within main first of all declare size. I am taking only 2, 2, 3 and two variables I and j, right? And now we are going to enter this matrix. So I think first of all it should print like enter elements of matrix. It should ask something like this, right? And now we are going to use obviously the logic that has nested for loops for this. Outer for loop is for rows and inner for loop would be for number of columns, I mean to print actual values, to take values in columns. J plus plus. क्या कर रही हूँ मैं अभी, सॉरी. scanf, एंड इन scanf द फॉर्मूला इज लाइक सिंटैक्स इज एड्रेस ऑफ ए ऑफ आई जे, राइट? आई थिंक दैट्स इट. नाउ आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू कॉपी दिस ओनली, दिस फॉर लूप ओनली. ओके, and first of all we are going to print this matrix, and then we are going to find the transpose. So that is why I'm going to paste it two times. So this is, we are going to print the matrix. So before this, let me write down one line like printf matrix is whatever you have entered, what matrix you have entered, that would be printed here, right? So rather than scanf here, only the changes, we will use printf, and I have removed address of ij, address of operator. Like this is going to print, and now these for loop would be printing transpose of matrix, right? And okay, transpose of matrix, let me write down one semicolon, right? And now here we have to change what rows would be 3, so 0 to 3, so, and inner loop would be from 0 to 2. And how you will print here? Printf percentage d a of ji, I guess it's clear to you now. So here we are also adding one more line, that is slash n, one more printf, right? And here also you have to add this one, just for the proper format, right? I guess it's done now. Let me run this program and enter the element of matrix. 6. Okay, I haven't used slash 3. It's okay. See, matrix is, I have entered 1 to 6 values. So, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. This kind of matrix. And obviously, transpose would be 1, 2, 3 here and 4, 5, 6 in this line. So, I guess it's correct. Here, you can add what rather than slash t, maybe you can do here some space. Like here, I am just writing slash t, right? And you can print, it will give a proper format, right? So, I hope this is clear to you. So, now in the next video, we will discuss one more program on matrix. And if you want any specific program on matrix, you can tell me in comment box. Now, I will see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye. Take care.